All right, so I'm picking up with you guys. It's going to be late in the afternoon, Sunday, about 5:30. Didn't really have the time this weekend for an official video. Spent a lot of my time outside of the garage doing things. We have an unseasonably warm November here, and so taking advantage of the last of the warm days before everything crashes and it becomes nice and blue or nice and white outside and I'm freezing to death. But in between my time out of the garage, I was working on this. This is an old Sony Super Beta machine. This is a model SL-HF650, I believe. Picked this up off local marketplace type of thing. Paid 40 bucks for this. Offered the guy 20, but he said no, so I went ahead and gave him the 40. If I would have looked the machine over just a little closer, I probably wouldn't have bought it at all. It had been sitting in an environment where it got wet on the bottom, and there's the bottom lid of it. I've sanded off quite a bit of the rust, or I've sanded off all of the rust, and of course the bottom of it looks pretty bad. And there's quite a bit of damage to the frame as well. So I wound up sanding away all of that and just kind of painting over it with some Krylon black paint, just so I didn't have to look at the areas I'd sanded on. Did the same thing kind of in the bottom, took the power supply all the way out, and there was quite a bit of rust down in there. Strangely enough, it didn't seem to affect any of the circuitry. There was some surface rust on the shields for some of the tuning and things like that, but otherwise, we've got a pretty good picture and real good audio as far as playback is concerned, real good. But this has taken on kind of a life of its own. It's one of those projects where you do one thing and then you got to do another thing and then, well, maybe I should do this, and way more time than I should have spent on this. But it is working. Let's bring the audio up a little bit. And as far as the record quality, the picture is not that great. This one has that issue where it has kind of an invisible line that kind of comes and goes, or excuse me, a visible line that kind of comes and goes in the picture. I don't think it's anything to do with headwear. I believe back in the day there was some type of a modification you could do to fix that issue, but I don't recall what it is now. But I'm not going to mess with it any further. This is going to go to its new home, and then if the new owner of this wants to play with that, they're certainly welcome to address it and fix it. But I will give you a sample of the record quality of this. And as far as the audio is concerned, it's right on the money. Let's go ahead and get something started over here on the laptop. Okay, let's bring it up there. Thank you. All right, let's go ahead. Let's back it up and check it out. Let's see. You can see there's a line there. I'm not sure why it's got the static when you're putting it in pause either. That's another thing. Yeah, I mean, audio-wise, it's right on the money. And the line and the picture kind of comes and kind of goes. Sometimes it's there and sometimes not. So, as I recall, it seems to me like I remember some kind of modification to prevent that from happening. But I don't remember now what it is. So, we'll leave that to the new owner. And then maybe they can pursue that. But one thing for sure, the display tube on this one is nice and strong. There's not a lot of burn-in here. And this front lens has a lot of scratching and scarring. So when the face is off of it, the display is nice and bright. So this is going to be I think it's going to be a great machine for somebody that already owns one of these that has really good cosmetics. And maybe you have some kind of an audio issue, or maybe you even have a head issue. This would be a great machine to take parts from and rebuild one that's in much better cosmetic shape. So that's really it. That's what I've been spending my time on, and way too much time. So if anybody's keeping up, if you're a frequent watcher of the channel, got a couple of outstanding things I'll give you some updates on. The Akai reel-to-reel for Franz, that is waiting for the key controller IC. According to the tracking information, that is in the United States, but it hasn't made it to me yet. So if we receive that next week, that's going to be next week's video, finishing that up. If not, I did receive another viewer-submitted unit. Unfortunately, it is a video project. It's a Sony LaserDisc player. So if we don't receive the IC for the reel-to-reel, that'll be next week's project, the Sony LaserDisc player. So that's really it. As always, I want to thank you guys very much. Appreciate you checking out the video. Even though this wasn't an official video this week, I do appreciate you stopping by, checking things out, and we'll pick back up, hopefully resuming as normal next week. So, as always, thank you. And if you're new to this channel, appreciate you checking things out. And hopefully you find something here that you holds your interest a little bit, I guess you would say. So, until next week, thank you guys very much. Appreciate it. Oh, and I did forget, the other outstanding unit we have is Joe, who has sent me several JVC Hi-Fi VCRs. He went ahead and supplied his own parts for the one, the 5800U that I was working on that had the audio issue. That board, that audio board, I could not get that repaired to the point to where it would take audio in. I got both channels restored for audio out, but I couldn't get it to the point where it would take audio in. So he supplied his own parts. So I do still have that project outstanding as well. And we have Mike's B&K receiver, which will be shipped back tomorrow. Everything went fine with that after extended testing of that unit. So that'll be sent back to him tomorrow. So that's it. Thank you guys. Appreciate it.